Welcome to Overthinking Eurovision. I'm Matt Rather, and for the first time ever, we are doing a two-parter to discuss a single Eurovision song. And we're doing it for maybe the dumbest song ever, Norway's entry in Eurovision 2022. Last time, we discussed a couple theories about who is behind those masks.
They're alien replicants from beyond the moon!
Now it's time to figure out what the hell those guys are actually talking about.
Not sure I've told you, but I really like your teeth. That hairy coat of yours with nothing underneath.
So we're doing Little Red Riding Hood here, but it's a little confusing because they are singing as Little Red Riding Hood while dressed as wolves. And there's some kind of shift that happens between the verses and choruses. In the verses, the Red Riding Hood character is super friendly to the wolf, even suggesting that they go to Grandma's house because... But then, in the choruses, she wants to save the grandma via banana. We were thinking this duality was meant to represent the war between the id and the superego, the temptation to succumb to a self-destructive hunger, only barely kept at bay by family loyalty, and then we realized that we were overthinking it, and we asked a small child to explain it to us.
Well, my third song, Eurovision song from Norway, gives that wolf a banana. It's really not that complicated, though it's easy to overthink. It's kind of funny. I mean, I'm not sure you have a name, so I will call you Keith. That's pretty funny. Like, if you just heard about the song, and you need to have the lyrics sung to you to actually understand it. That's kind of how I feel.
Thanks for clearing that up, Alex. Let us know if you figure out Serbia. We're not the only ones looking for deeper meaning behind the banana. The most popular theory is that this is a veiled pro-vaccination song. The wolf is COVID, it's out there killing, and its favorite target is the elderly. Luckily, there's a way to protect those vulnerable populations.
Give that wolf banana.
The banana is a vaguely syringe-shaped item that temporarily satisfies the wolf. Notice that the wolf is not killed or even totally full. It's going to be hungry again later, perhaps requiring further booster bananas. But for now, the banana will keep Grandma safe, or at least improve her odds. It's a clever explanation. Overthinking game, recognize overthinking game. And Subwoofer has been asked about it directly in an interview with Eurovox.tv. They said, "The lyrics are immensely layered. Why would anyone write a song with a title as ridiculous as Give That Wolf a Banana unless there was a deeper meaning?" Now, maybe sarcasm works differently on the moon, but it sounds like they're mocking the whole idea that there is any deeper meaning, which is not to say that it's not about COVID, despite the band being coy, but it does recall a line from Dr. Strangelove.
"Whole point of the doomsday machine is lost.
If you keep it a secret, why didn't you tell the world, eh?"
If the song is meant to promote vaccines, why not, you know, promote vaccines? Why hide the message so that 99.9% of your listeners just think it's a silly song about a wolf? Well, one possible explanation is that since COVID vaccination is still controversial for reasons that are too complex and depressing to go into, Subwoofer feels like they need to keep its intentions a secret until the right moment. Maybe the idea is that once they win Eurovision, or at least break the top 10, they can use the international spotlight to reveal their true agenda. This reminds us of what happened with the Insane Clown Posse. Since the early 90s, the hip-hop duo was known for their ultra-violent and misogynistic lyrics.
"We've got multiple individuals committing gang-related crimes, and they're using the name Jonah Lowe."
But in 2010, the Guardian newspaper revealed that they were secretly evangelical Christians. And their entire 20-year history, it was merely about winning over a generation of fans so that they could learn the good news about our Lord and Savior. According to head juggalo Violent J, you have to speak their language. You have to interest them, gain their trust, talk to them, and show you're one of them. Then in the end, you can tell them, "God has helped me." So perhaps Subwoofer is pulling an Insane Clown Posse here. They have a message that might turn some people off, so they hide it within a song that on the surface doesn't challenge anyone. And then at the moment of maximum viral impact, boom, Dr. Anthony Fauci appears as one of the backup dancers on stage at Turin. Since this is overthinking it though, I feel like we have to suggest an even more complex interpretation of the song. So here it goes. Bananas are a famously good source of potassium. And over the past couple months, potassium has been in the headlines, specifically potassium iodide tablets, which are supposed to provide protection from thyroid cancer after exposure to nuclear radiation. As Russia's invasion of Ukraine escalated, they ended up fighting a pitched battle inside the Chernobyl exclusion zone, raising the risk of radioactive material getting yeeted into the atmosphere. So perhaps the wolf eating the grandma is a metaphor for Russia's war of conquest. The banana is meant to provide some protection against the danger. But in this reading, the banana is supposed to be comically insufficient. Giving a wolf a banana is not going to protect anybody from getting eaten, and taking potassium iodide is not going to keep anybody safe from the consequences of Russian aggression. What Subwoofer is trying to tell us is that the global community needs to get much tougher and come at the wolf with something much more intimidating than a banana, or risk appearing just as foolish and helpless as Little Red Riding Hood. On the other hand, Give That Wolf a Banana could also just be a silly song. Bananas are the funniest of fruits. They were funny in the 1917 Harold Lloyd classic, The Flirt, and they were funny in Despicable Me.
Banana.
And a Hooked on a Feeling style bridge where banana is chanted intensely is just funny, whether or not it means anything. Now, of course, there's one more theory about this song. Perhaps this is all just brilliant viral marketing from the Chiquita Corporation. Think about how many times I've said the word banana today. Way more than usual. And after these guys win in Turin, their faces will be on a little sticker on every banana you'll peel for the next 10 years. We'll see you next time. Well played, Chiquita. Even Don Draper couldn't have come up with this. But maybe the fact that Subwoofer is yellow should have tipped us off.